Hey everybody, welcome back to the laboratory. Dr. Kranke here with you. I wanted to say thanks for all the wonderful comments you've been leaving and suggestions, and I'm just really happy and pleased with the way things are going. So I wanted to talk about masking. Rip Gabby, one of the guys on there, asked me if I could help him out with some masking. Simple masking, you know, the kind that you would do on a low rider. And so I'm going to walk you through a little bit of that, although my masking jobs are never going to be that intricate, in part because I much prefer to use templates and things like that. But I mean, I could do it. So I'm going to walk you through quickly the kind of materials that you're going to need. The first order of business is getting yourself a big, heavy, not so heavy, you know, quarter of an inch will do just fine. A piece of glass, all right? I don't know where this came from. I want to say probably Home Depot. You could get glass fairly cheap. And as you can see here, I've added tape. And this is a wonderful product that I get from Coast Airbrush. And it's Hobby Mask. It comes in a big roll like this. It's about 15 bucks. But it's 6 inches by I don't know how many feet you get into in this, but it's a lot, and you won't run out of it. It's they sell it for the hobby market, but you can get it as big as you want if you're doing a real car, say. But anyway, the reason why you use a glass is because you want to have a very clean surface that you can cut on. All right, and you want the tape to stick on without getting a lot of residue. So this is the hobby mask that I put on here, and these are just strips of this kind of tape, which is what I use for cutting thinner strips. All right, so I'm going to walk you through that in another segment, probably coming right up after this one. But anyway, you see I started drawing stuff out, and you keep this clean with Windex. You use razor blades like this. I get them by the hundreds, and a pack of 100 is not that expensive, and it's going to last forever. And you scrape the glass clean. You clean it with Windex or another glass cleaner. Even alcohol will do it. Then you lay down your tape. Then you take your measurements. You start cutting your strips of tape as thin or as thick as you want them, and that's it. And when it's time to remove them, you just, you know, you could, I've cut a few little strips here. You know, you can go easy. I don't have any fingernails because I'm a nervous person and I chew them up. But anyway, see, that's how I'm trying to see if you can. You probably can't even see it because it's so thin. But there's a little strip right there. There it is. See, that's about, I don't know, 1/16 of an inch, something like that, probably even smaller than that. And so this is good. Be careful with it because you don't want to break it. Also, if you need a guide, you know, a grid, just put your grid board right underneath it, and you, like that, and you're good to go. All right. So, other things that you're going to need, these calipers, which are handy, and these are fairly inexpensive. You can get them, again, at one of those big stores. And the reason why I use it is for taking measurements, exact measurements, and then transferring them over to the paper, and then being able to cut. So you can measure the sides of your vehicles, the hood, everything. Even when you're doing the interior, it's all good. It's a good tool to have around. The other thing you're going to need are these French curves. You can get a set at Michael's for dirt cheap. If you can get a metal, even better. But plastic will do just fine, and you could draw your designs and then cut your tape, okay? Measuring tools and cutting tools, all right? Triangles, anything, you know, from geometry class that you've kept around. It's good. You got one of these protractors, I guess. I don't know, for getting angles. So you could go crazy on this stuff, but the basics is just a good cutting blade, tape, a glass, and then your vehicle. And then, as you can see, I started working on this. This is a car that I just painted, and I'm not crazy about this. I'm going to change it, especially when I walk you through a little bit of the taping, which I'm going to start with the roof here. in a minute. So that's basically all you need, and a lot of patience. I mean, to do a multi-layered paint job like that, it's going to take a long time. I'm usually not patient enough, which is why I always go back to my templates, because you can get circles, you can get squares, you can get anything you want in a template, but you could also mask jobs come in handy. So anyway, I'll walk you through that in a moment or two. The other thing I wanted to say is thanks to everybody, in particular FastJimmy71. Man, your work is really inspirational, and I love that Camaro you built, and I hope you keep building, because you're a great influence, and it's just fun to watch you at work. Pete Turley, there's a whole bunch of guys on the tube that are doing fabulous work, and so I really appreciate you being around and doing your videos. And so, you know, the energy is a communal energy. It all goes around, and it helps other builders at no matter what skill level. So I still have a heck of a lot to learn, you know, so it's going to be fun just being around watching you guys. So stay tuned in, and we'll give you some more in just a few moments. Moments in YouTube means maybe a couple of days. So just stay tuned in, and I really appreciate you coming in and watching over my shoulder. So until next time, be good and do good work. All right.